no doubt is an obstacle. And al-a'iq al-khamis, the fifth obstacle, and this is indeed an important obstacle that we need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from. And that is al-ujub wal-kibr. And that is al-ujub wal-ghurur wal-kibr. And that is self-amazement and arrogance. And this comes under the main a'iq, which is al-ma'asi, sins. This comes under the main obstacle, which is sins. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, al-ladhina ihtadaw zadahum huda, that those who follow the guidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase them in guidance. وَأَتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ, and they will indeed obtain taqwa. الَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا, those who indeed comply, meaning they do the fi'l lawamir, they do those acts that have been commanded, and stay away from the nawahi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will indeed increase them in huda. And Rabi' ibn Anas, rahimullah ta'ala, he said, زَادَهُمْ عِلْمًا, those who اهْتَدَوْا, those who follow the commandments and stay away from the prohibitions, Allah will increase them in knowledge. This is the meaning of huda here, yani ilma. Wa atahum taqwahum, and he will give them indeed righteousness and taqwa. So this is an important affair generally, and that is leaving sins. But from the most despicable of sins that a student of knowledge can fall into is the main one I'm mentioning here, and that is al-ujub. And that is indeed self-amazement and arrogance. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, he said, إِنِّي لَأَحْسِبُ الرَّجُلُ يَنْسَى الْعِلْمِ يَتَعَلَّمُهُ بِخَطِيئَةٍ يَعْمَلُهَا. He says, I see that a man forgets knowledge that he has studied due to a sin that he indeed has fallen into. أو بِذَنْبٍ يَعْمَلُهُ. And Abu Wahab al-Marwazi, rahimullah ta'ala, he said, سَأَلْتُ Ibn Mubarak. I asked Ibn Mubarak, مَا الْكِبْرِ, what's arrogance? I asked Ibn Mubarak, rahimullah, what's arrogance? قَالَ أَنْ تَزْدَرِيَ النَّاسِ, to look down upon the people. فَسَأَلْتُهُ عَنِ الْعُجُبِ, and then I asked him, what's self-amazement? قَالَ اسْمَعُ أَنْ تَرَى أَنَّ عِنْدَكَ شَيْئًا لَيْسَ عِنْدَ غَيْرِكَ. أَنْ تَرَى أَنَّ عِنْدَكَ شَيْئًا لَيْسَ عِنْدَ غَيْرِكَ, and that is that you believe that you have something that others don't have. You have knowledge you think that others don't have. You have that confidence, self-amazement. And then he said, لَا أَعْلَمُ فِي الْمُصَلِّينَ شَيْئًا شَرًّا مِنَ الْعُجْبِ. I don't know anything more destructive and evil for the praying person than self-amazement. And self-amazement, barakallahu fikum, is haram. The person who falls into that indeed is falling into haram, as is mentioned by Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, لِأَنْهُ نَوْعٌ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ. Aynan. Is نَوْعٌ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ. It's a type of association with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ بِنْ تَيْمِيَةَ, شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ بِنْ تَيْمِيَةَ رَحِمُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, he said, وَكَثِيرًا مَا يُقْرَنُ الرِّيَاءُ بِالْعُجُبِ, and that which is mentioned along with showing off is self-amazement. So two entities here, showing off and what? Self-amazement. He said, فَالرِّيَاءُ مِنْ بَابِ الْإِشْرَاكِ بِالْخَلْقِ. So showing off is associating partners with Allah, with the creation. Obviously not that shirk that takes you out of Islam, minor shirk of course. But when one shows off, they are associating partners in that regard with the creation, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And al-ujub min bab al-ishraq bin nafs. Wal-ujub min bab al-ishraqi bin nafs. So the one that is showing off is associating partners with Allah with the creation, because he's doing that, what he does for the creation. But the one that is self-amazed, this is ishraq also. You are associating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in partners yourself. Which is why he said, rahimahullah ta'ala, وَهَذَا حَالَ الْمُسْتَكْبِرِ وَهَذَا حَالُ الْمُسْتَكْبِرِ. This is the state of the arrogant one, the haughty one. فَالْمُرَائِ, so the one that shows off, لَا يُحَقِّقُ قَوْلَهُ إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. The one that shows off has not implemented Fully the statement of Allah, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ, to you alone we worship. Because he's associating others with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in showing off and doing acts for the creation. So he hasn't implemented that portion of the verse fully. وَالْمُعْجِبُ يَعْلِي لِنَفْسِهِ لَا يُحَقِّقُ قَوْلَهُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. The one that is self-amazed has not implemented إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ, because the meaning of إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ, to you alone we seek aid. It's a verse that humbles, that makes you realize that you're faqir, that you're in need. So you seek aid from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the arrogant ones has that ujub, that haughtiness that does not indeed show his implementation of iyyaka nasta'in. And again, al-ujub, self-amazement, is an obstacle because it's a sign of ignorance. It's a sign of ignorance. It's alamat al-jahl. As is mentioned by Abu Darda again, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, where he says, alamat al-jahli thalath. There are three signs of ignorance. May Allah protect us from all of them. Three signs of ignorance. No matter how much you think you've memorized, or how much you think you know, there are three types and signs of ignorance. The first is al-ujub. The first is al-ujub, yani self-amazement. The second is kathratul mantiq fima la ya'ni, yani speaking about that which does not concern you. That's the second one. وَأَنْ يَنْهَى عَنْ شَيْءٍ وَيَأْتِي. وَأَنْ يَنْهَى عَنْ شَيْءٍ وَيَأْتِي. And that he prohibits and forbids something and he does it himself. These are the three, he said, Abu Darda, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, are the three signs of ignorance. What are the three signs of ignorance? Yalla. Number one. Huh? Al-ujub, self-amazement. Number two. Huh? Speak, كَذَةَ الْمَنْتَقْ فِي مَا لَا يَعْنِي, speaking regarding that which does not concern you. And number three, him doing something that he himself prohibits. Ali ibn Thabit, Malish, I'm giving you loads of narrations because their speech is better than mine. Ali ibn Thabit, rahimullahu ta'ala, yaqul, al-malu آفاته التبذير والنهب والعلم آفاته الإعجاب والغضب. Beautiful statement, which is mentioned by Ibn Abdi Barr in Jam Bayan al-Ilm wa Fadlih. He said, rahimullah, that the corruption of wealth is squandering it and wasting it. Spendthrift, yani spending on something that you don't need. This is the corruption of the way that wealth is corrupted. And knowledge is corrupted. Yani it's an obstacle. Something's an obstacle to knowledge. It corrupts knowledge. It hinders its progression. Al-i'jab, being self-amazed. Wal-ghadab, and anger. Yani for other than Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And this is why we find many people, may Allah protect us, trials with this. Al-ijab. And it leads to anger. It leads to hasad. It leads to enmity against the people of the sunnah. When you are not given the status that you believe you're worth. You hold yourself to be high status, which people don't know what's in your heart, so they're unaware. But that status that you believe that you deserve, when it's not given, you become a hater. You have this ghadab, this hate, this anger against those who do not give you the status that you believe you deserve. And that hinders your knowledge, and which is why some of the Salaf said, Al-mu'jib bin nafsihi la yakun mukhlisan, mustahil. The one that is self-amazed cannot be sincere, because he's always trying to make people believe he's the status that he thinks he's at. He has to prove to the people that he is indeed at the status that he believes he's at. And this, no doubt, is a hindrance. مَا صَنَعْتَ مَاذَا؟ You've done nothing. You've wasted your talab. May Allah protect us. Dhunun, rahimullahu ta'ala, yaqul. Arba khilal laha thamara. Again, some more numbers. Four characteristics. There are ramifications that come with these characteristics. The first one is al-ajala, hastiness. The second characteristic, okay, I'll mention the narration in meaning to keep it short. He says the first one is al-ajala, wa thamaratu al-ajala an-nadama. He said hastiness is the first characteristic. And its ramification is regret. Because there's no rewind. When one is hasty in statement or actions, no doubt there's tawbah. But the ramifications, no doubt, are severe. As the Arabs, they say, al-ajala umun nadama. That indeed, hastiness is the mother of regret. And then he says, wal-ujub. وَثَمَرَةُ الْعُجُبْ الْبُغْدْ يَسْمَعُ وَالْعُجُبْ Self-amazement, the ramifications of self-amazement is hatred. And again, as I explained to my dear beloved brothers, uncles and so forth, that the person holds himself to be at a status, and when not given that status, there's what comes, mother? Huh? بُغْد, hatred. Because you're not being fair. I'm supposed to be somebody, and you're not giving me my status that I deserve. This ujub, may Allah protect us. And then he says, wal-lajaja, not the jaja, bilam, wal-lajaja, yani argumentation, thamaratu lajaja al-hayra, confusion. The person who likes to argue, like these YouTubers, barakallahu fikum, and these people who like to just argue, the ramifications is confusion. Which is why the Salaf, they warned against it. And the fourth that he mentioned is sharih. Yani sheen raha. Sharihu. Asharihu. And asharihu is greediness. And the ramification of greediness is poverty. You want it so much, you become poor. You don't have this contentment, because you have this greediness. But the most important point here is al-ujub, ikhwa. It's self-amazement, he says, that the ramifications is hatred. Al-aiqasad is the sixth one, I mentioned that briefly, is a tadarruj fil-ilm. Or adam a tadarruj fil-ilm. Adam a tadarruj fil-ilm.